In this video, I'll walk you through the process of how to think strategically about the technology tools that you bring into your classroom. This video is actually taken from my brand new How to Teach with Technology Starter Kit, which you can access for free by going to newedtechclassroom.com/starterkit. My name is Sam Carey, and this is my YouTube channel for the new EdTech Classroom. One of the most common questions I get from teachers is just how to pick the right technology programs to use in their classrooms when there are so many tools to choose from. So in this lesson, we'll be looking at how to select technology tools based on the strategy that you're trying to put in place in your classroom. So again, rather than starting by picking a tool first, we'll instead start with what we want to accomplish and then select a tool that will help us achieve our goals. Learning which tools best align with specific objectives, of course, takes time. And by far the best way to learn is just through experience and trying things out in your classroom. You can identify a strategy that you want to put in place, like say increasing collaboration, and trial some different tools, and then see whether or not they're actually helping you increase collaboration. There are also lots of resources out there that can help you better understand which tools are best aligned to specific goals. Of course, one of those resources is the new EdTech Classroom, but there are also others like Common Sense, which I'll be showing you a little bit later in this course. I'll walk you through how I approach choosing tools that align to goals so that you can see how the process works. So let's start with the first high impact area of need to increase participation. Remember that for this area of need, we wanted to put an active participation strategy in place. After you've identified your strategy, the next step is to think about what you want out of a tool. So in order to put an active participation strategy in place where students are doing things at all times in class, we're going to want a tool that helps us ask for mandatory participation as opposed to voluntary participation, a tool that allows for varied responses. So it's not just students raising a hand or talking as a way to participate, but giving them some choices like being able to draw, record audio, even record a short video response. And then I also want to look for a tool that's relatively easy to implement so that the active participation can be frequent and occurring at all times during a lesson. There are lots of tools that meet these criteria and that can help us put an active participation strategy in place. And two suggested tools are Nearpod or Whiteboard Fi. Nearpod would be a good choice if you need pre-created lessons and if you don't want to deal with sending students out to lots of different websites because it's a self-contained program. On the other hand, Whiteboard Fi is a digital whiteboard program that allows you to give every student an individual whiteboard that they can use to record responses and then show those responses back to you. You might want to choose a digital whiteboard program if you do a lot of direct instruction and just need to see really quickly whether or not students are grasping the concepts that you're teaching. For the next area of need to increase academic achievement, recall that the strategy that we were going to put in place was to chunk the content that we provided students and to embed checks for understanding in that content whenever possible. So for example, instead of just reading an article and then answering some questions about it afterwards and maybe not finding out whether those answers were correct until several days later, I would want a tool that would give students immediate feedback so that they could check for themselves whether or not they were understanding what it was that they were reading. Similarly, as the teacher, I would also want access to that information so that I could analyze who was understanding the material and who wasn't, which is going to allow me to do some targeted intervention and ultimately use that intervention to increase academic performance. Two tools that are effective for making content interactive in this way are Actively Learn and Edpuzzle. Edpuzzle is an interactive video platform that has a lot of pre-made content. So when you present educational videos to students, rather than having them just watch it from start to finish, instead, you can have them watch an Edpuzzle video that has embedded checks for understanding throughout the entire video. Actively Learn also has an interactive video feature, and in addition to interactive video, Actively Learn also has a huge archive of texts that are already interactive, and you can also customize those texts to add your own interactive questions. In addition to nonfiction articles, you can also make short stories, poems, and even entire books interactive. and you can upload web page URLs to pull in a website and make that interactive, and even upload PDFs to add interactive questions to those too. If you're finding this video helpful, be sure to hit the like button, and remember that this video is actually part of an entire How to Teach with Technology starter kit that you can get for free. I put the link in the video description and in the pinned comment. You can also get it by going to newedtechclassroom.com/starter kit. For the last area of need to increase student engagement, we're going to put a strategy in place to introduce assessments of learning that have some real-world applicability, that are meaningful, and that are authentic. So really, we want to get students invested in the process of making a final product here so that they will also be invested in doing all the learning pieces that lead up to creating that final product. It's also important that we have some way for students to publish their work if we're going to have them create something. So we don't just want it to be something that they just give to the teacher. What I would be looking for in a tool here would be a tool that is going to have some real world applicability. It might be a tool that people actually use in the real world to publish information, to get the word out about who they are, to get their message out into the world. And two tools that I like for this are Canva and Book Creator. Canva is a program that will allow you to do all kinds of different creativity projects with students, like graphic designs, presentations, videos. There's a lot more in there as well. You can get a free Canva for Education account. And one of the benefits of using Canva is that it's a program that professionals use. Students often know this, they recognize the name, and that in and of itself can be a motivating factor. Also, of course, when you teach students how to use a program like Canva, that has some clear real-world applicability that transcends your individual classroom. And then a program like Book Creator is also a program that real authors use to publish ebooks, and you can use it to have students make multimedia rich digital books that they can then publish to a class library. You can share those books around with other students, with parents, and they can even publish those books in the real world. So again, it has that real world applicability. There are all kinds of other creativity apps that you can bring into your classroom, and bringing these types of assessments of learning into your classroom is really a key factor in getting students invested and engaged with the work that you are doing. So just to recap, in this video, we looked at how to choose the right EdTech tools based on looking at the strategy you're trying to put in place and then identifying what you would want out of a tool. I gave you some ideas about tools that you might want to use to get started. In the next lesson, I'll also be showing you where you can go out and find tools on your own that align to your particular areas of need. Thanks for watching this video to the end. If you want to learn more about how to use education technology in your classroom, be sure to watch that playlist above. And if you're looking for free resources as well as a free course to help you get started with teaching with technology, be sure to go to newedtechclassroom.com/starter kit to get your free starter kit, as well as over 20 free resources for you to take and use in your classroom.